movie. Yeah.
Hey, welcome back to We Watched a Movie. I'm Mike and he's Jay, and today we're reviewing Skyfall, clearly.
007 is presumed dead after a mishap with MI6. He comes back, there's a new baddie on the loose, Javier Bardem. And James Bond is trying to get himself back into the super secret agent life again and go after this guy.
Someone stole a chip with a hard drive with all the agents' names and like where
and
they are.
Threatening releasing the information to the public.
So
this is really like an internal battle within MI6.
Yeah,
like this guy's attacking MI6 within.
Yeah, everything's in shambles.
Yeah, that's it.
It's all in shambles.
It felt like a James Bond movie, and it sounded like a James Bond movie, but it just, for me, I just wanted more from it.
Yeah, well, I mean, there is a lot of dialogue, and the movie runs at almost 2.5 hours, so I agree with you in that I think the movie could have been chopped down about 20-25 minutes and felt a lot better. But the thing is with Quantum of Solace, I just watched that today, with Quantum of Solace, it was just like nonstop action scene after action scene, and it was kind of a hard to follow story. And I get that they weren't trying to do that with this one, but the action scenes in this were short but sweet, I felt like. Every time there was an action scene, like you said, you're right, it was short, but they were done so well and so, like, stylized that, like, every single time there was an action scene, it was amazing. The realism is still there that you love from the first two Bonds, but they also add in the sleekness and the style and the flair that all the old Tommy James Bonds had. This movie kind of crosses that bridge from Daniel Craig territory into the classic Bond territory without going over the top. It's more style, less action.
For me, there was a few scenes that I were like really, I got excited about, like as far as like the beginning of the movie, there's a car chase scene and a motorcycle scene that was awesome, it was badass, and it sets you up nice, but then like it's just like it's like bittersweet for me because you get these, like you were saying, short little sequences of action and then you get nothing. To me, like everybody has their own version of James Bond. Everybody has their different like take on James Bond. I like I like Daniel Craig's James Bond take. I mean, I was a fan of Pierce Brosnan, but I like that raw edginess thing that Daniel Craig brought to the role. I'm not much of a fan of the older James Bond stuff. I know that's blasphemous for a lot of people, but I'm just not. I like the newer, like edgy action in your face shit.
Daniel Craig as Bond, his character is as rough as he ever has been in the other movies. Like he's even more so because he's going through all this stuff. He's still the same like rough and edgy character, but the movie around him is way more, like I keep going back to the word stylized, it's the only way I know how to put it, you know, but the movie around him is more like the old Tommy James Bonds, like you were saying.
Yeah,
so it depends on which kind of fan you are. This one kind of bridges the gap in between.
The story itself is not bad. I mean it seems pretty cool that there's an internal battle because it's never been done, like MI6 is actually being attacked, like that's pretty cool. The thing is, the bad guy himself and what his goals are, to me, I think it was stupid. I don't really like his. I didn't think his goals were like worthy of a James Bond villain almost. And Javier is a great, great villain. Like he's an awesome actor, and I just think they could have done more with him. And they just left. Like I just don't think they wanted to take the extra step and make him what he was. Like in No Country for Old Men, that guy was scary. Like he was edgy. He was scary. You didn't. And there's a scene in this film where he is almost at that point, but he doesn't go there. Like, they just refuse to let him go there.
But it takes him a while to bring him on screen, and I thought he was great. I thought he was awesome. I thought, you know, his lines were good. He was a wild card. He didn't know what he was going to do next. There's one scene where they delve into his history, and he, like, shows something that happened to him.
That's what I was saying. But
and that was amazing looking. That was really well done. And Javier Bardem did a great job, but I agree with you that he wasn't fleshed out as well as he could have been. He produces what's a problem in a lot of James Bond movies. He produces an actual physical threat, but they don't tap into that.
When you think of a James Bond villain, you think, you know, over huge goals of what they're going to do. This guy's got a simple goal, and that's fine, but it just seems thuggish. It just doesn't seem like a James Bond villain for me.
Yeah, we got to talk about, there's a moment of homoeroticness in this film. And we won't give anything away about it. Like, we'll let you experience it for yourself, but it's out there, man. Like, when it comes on screen, you're like, what the fuck? I was trying to hold it in, but then it goes a step further, and the guy behind me was like,
and
I finally burst it out and laughed, and I couldn't help myself.
Like, there was a guy behind me, and I heard him talk to his girlfriend. When that whole scene was going, he was like, no way. No way. And, like, it was like the whole freaking theater. You could feel the uncomfortableness rising. And yeah. It was like, it was like if you're watching TV, and then a porn channel comes on, and with your mom, you're like, what the fuck?
I loved the James Bond coming back where he was just like broken down and he wasn't sure if he could do the job anymore, and he's kind of he's trying to get his groove back. I love that whole thing. Like, it just goes back to the edginess when he was a rookie from Casino Royale, and I thought that was amazing. Javier Bardem was a great guy. They flesh out a lot more of James Bond's history in this than they've ever really done before, like far back into his history, and I loved every bit of that. For Bond fans, I think you'll all enjoy that a lot.
The Q James Bond interaction was cool. I liked it a lot. I thought they delivered that really well.
Yeah, they do a great job with throwbacks to the old James Bond days. They bring in some, like, there's little quotes and stuff like that throughout the movie. Bond fans are probably going to love this film just because they bring back a lot of stuff. It's just, I think that there was a lot of hype going into this film, and I don't think it quite lived up to that hype, but I still think it was a great Bond movie.
I loved Casino Royale. I thought that was a perfect blend of action and story. Mm-hmm. This just had a lot of story that they tried to blend with action. I just don't think it worked.
If Quantum of Solace has all these action scenes, but they're over the top and special effects oriented,
yeah.
This film has stylized fight sequences, and it's more sleek and it's more well shot with less special effects. And I absolutely love the action sequences.
Yeah, I mean, there was one, like, and sometimes they're really fast. Like, there's one scene where he comes and, like, kicks this guy in the face and breaks his neck, and it's just like that, but you're like, damn.
That was a cool scene.
Yeah, and it was like
5 seconds long. Yeah. I'm gonna give this movie an 8.0. I think it's a great Bond movie. Doesn't quite beat Casino Royale for me. I think Casino Royale is still the best Daniel Craig Bond. And I loved what they did with James Bond's character. From beginning to end, James Bond was perfect.
I'm going
to
give it a 7.5. I thought it looked good. It sounded good. It was shot well. The dialogue scenes, a lot of them, I don't think they were needed. They were necessary, but they wanted to make it different and they wanted to explain more about James Bond history. That's cool. But I think they chose to go heavily on the story rather than the action, which is fine, and I understand people enjoy that.
It's a good to great James Bond movie, but it's definitely not the best of the series.
I would think
people have been handling it.
I think the general consensus when we were leaving the theater, most people were like, it was all right.
Yeah.
You're not going to go in, you're not going to come out, it's like, holy shit.
Yeah.
It's just set with your face.
I don't think it's going to blow anybody's mind like it did some of the other critics. All right then, Money Pussy.
Okay.
So, anyways, guys, question of the day. What do you prefer? Do you prefer Daniel Craig's James Bond, the new style, or do you prefer the old classic gadgetry style?
Connery.
James Bond. Let us know. Comment below. I'm Mike. He's Jay. We'll see you next time when we watch the movie.
Bye, Em.
Money Pussy.
My name's Money Penny. We watched a movie.